Hello everyone, welcome to pfox.com. This is Arun Motori. In this Selenium automation tutorial series, I am going to continue with the topic XPath expression locators. As part of this topic, I have already covered 26 parts in the previous videos. In the current video session, I am going to cover the 27th part of this XPath expression locators, guys, that is child XPath AXES. So what is child XPath AXES? So let's get started, guys. As a prereq side, guys, you should already know what exactly is XPath AXES. So if you are not aware of this XPath AXES, refer my previous video, guys, where I explained in detail what exactly the XPath AXES is. Okay, so let's move to the next slide, guys. Child XPath AXES. So child XPath AXES selects or locates the child tags of the current tag in the HTML document. For example, guys, we have located a particular tag using the XPath expression. Okay, then on the top, then with that XPath expression, if you use this child XPath AXES, you can locate all the child tags of the located tag. Okay, this statement looks confusing anyhow. Let me practically show you one example so that you can understand what exactly child XPath AXES will do. Okay, in real time. So let me open the sample application, guys, that is compendiumdev.co.uk/selenium/basic_web_page.html in this Chrome browser. So when you get this simple page, right click on some blank page and select inspect option. So the Chrome developer options will be displayed. As you can see, by default the elements tag is selected. If not, just select this elements tag, guys. All the HTML code for this particular page will be displayed below. Okay, this is a complete HTML code of this particular page. Okay, fine. Now let me explain what exactly the child AXES, okay, child XPath AXES is. So guys, let's take an example where, okay, let's take an example where you have to locate this let's say you have to locate this head tag. Okay, let's take an example where you have to locate this head tag, but assume that you are not able to create an XPath expression that can locate this head tag due to some XYZ reasons. Okay, its location is not getting possible. In such cases, guys, what you can do is you can locate this HTML tag. Okay, just locate this HTML tag, which is the parent of this head tag. Okay, using some XPath expression. Now, with the help of this XPath expression of this HTML tag, use child XPath AXES to locate this head tag, because head is a child of this HTML tag. So instead of direct, if direct location of this head tag is not possible, then locate the parent of the head tag, that is HTML tag, and use a child XPath AXES to locate the child tags. Same applies for the body tag also, guys. For example, if you're not able to locate this body tag directly, which is nothing but child tag of HTML tag, in that case, locate this HTML tag, okay, with some XPath expression and use child XPath AXES to locate the child tags of this HTML tag, that is body tag. And here also few examples are there. As you can see, there are two paragraphs, guys. Let's say you are not able to locate this particular paragraph. Okay, assume that in that case you will locate the parent tag, that is body tag, and with the help of the child XPath AXES, you will locate the first bit paragraph tag. Okay, like that. Okay, if you are not able to locate the child tags, guys, locate the parent tag and then use the child XPath AXES to locate the child tags of the located parent tags. So let's switch to the presentation mode now. So guys, hope you have understood now what exactly the child XPath AXES will do. Okay, so with the help of the XPath expression and using this child XPath AXES, we can locate the child tags of the current located tag. Okay, that I explained just now. So let's move to the next slide, guys, where we have all these different examples, so which I am going to practically demonstrate it for you. So these particular examples will build your confidence on this child XPath AXES, guys. Okay, even though you didn't understand, if you have not understood in the previous slides, you can understand it here. Okay, so I will be practically demonstrating all the child XPath AXES examples one after the another one. Let me switch to the practical mode now. So open the sample application, guys, that is compendiumdev.co.uk/selenium/basic-web-page.html in the Chrome browser. This particular simple web page will be loaded for you. Right click on some blank area and say right click here, and then select inspect option. The HTML code for this particular page will be displayed here. Okay, complete HTML code of this complete HTML page will be displayed here. Now let's move to the demonstration part, guys. Let's locate the. It's saying that we have to locate the HTML tag, and using the HTML tag, we need to locate the child tag of HTML, that is head tag. So let me explain in a different way. For example, guys, you wanted to locate this head tag. You wanted to locate this head tag, but unfortunately, assume that you are not able to locate this head tag directly with some XPath expressions due to some XYZ reasons. Okay. In that case, what you will do? You can locate this parent tag of this head tag, that is HTML tag, and then using that, using after locating this HTML tag along with that XPath expression, if you use child XPath AXES, then you can locate the head tag. Okay. With the help of the parent tag, you will locate the head tag using the child XPath AXES. So let me go to the crow path and demonstrate it to you practically. Okay, select this relative XPath. Now first, since you cannot locate this head tag directly, I will locate this parent of this head tag, that is HTML tag. How to locate the HTML tag? //HTML, enter. Okay, you see the HTML tag got located as XPath one is got added to this HTML tag. Now since HTML is the parent of the head tag, and since we are not able to locate this head tag directly, what we'll do is we'll concatenate this relative XPath expression with some XPath AXES, that is child XPath AXES. Okay, so child of HTML, that is :: what is the child that we want to locate, guys? Head. Okay, if you're not able to locate the head tag directly, we'll come from the HTML tag, which is the parent, and then use child XPath AXES and then locate the head tag. So when you press enter, guys, one element is getting located, that is nothing but the head tag is getting located, guys. You see XPath is called one is there in the head tag. Similarly, let's locate another tag, that is body tag. Even body is also the child of the HTML. Let's say, guys, you wanted to locate the body tag, but unfortunately, assume that the created XPath expressions are not locating this body tag directly. Okay, due to some XYZ problems, not able to locate this body tag directly with the XPath expressions. So in that case, what you can do? You can locate this parent tag. //HTML is the parent tag of the body tag. And by using this XPath expression and with the help of XPath AXES like child XPath AXES, :, if you say body, you'll be able to locate the body tag. So directly you are not able to locate, guys. You are coming first, you are locating the parent of this body tag, and then you are locating this body tag, which is a child tag, using this child XPath AXES. So this is another example. Now locate the title child tag with the help of the head tag. Okay, so what I mean to say is we need to locate this title tag, guys, with the help of the head tag. So first let's locate the head tag like this, //head. You see head tag got located, XPath is called one got added here to the head tag. That means head tag got located. Now using this head tag XPath expression, we need to locate this title tag. How it is possible? Simply you have to say forward, since title is the child tag of this head tag, we can simply say //child XPath AXES :: title, we have to say. You see, this part is locating the head tag. Now we located the child tag of the head tag, that is title tag, with the help of child XPath AXES. Title XPath is equal to one. That means title tag is getting located. Now let's move to the next example, guys. This is very simple, guys. Child tag is very simple to understand. Okay, locate the p child tags with the help of the body tag. Okay, with the help of the body tag, we need to locate the p child tags. So what I mean to say here is we have to locate this body tag, and with the help of that, we need to locate the paragraph tags, which are the child of this body tags. So for that, we have to first locate the body tag, guys. Okay, and now we need to locate these two p tags with the help of this body tag. How to do that? /give the child XPath AXES :: say p, enter. Okay, you see the first p tag having the XPath is equal to one, and second p tag having the XPath is equal to got located. That means these two elements, two paragraph tags got located. Okay, located. Now guys, out of these two paragraph tags, I want to locate only the first paragraph tag. Okay, first child tag of this body tag I want to locate. In that case, simply provide p of one, it will locate the first paragraph only. Okay, now if you give p of two, only the second paragraph will be located, like this. Fine. So we have to do like this, guys. Okay, we are done with the examples for this child XPath AXES. Now let's switch to the presentation mode. So guys, I have practically demonstrated all the examples that I have provided on this particular slide. Okay, so here ends this current video session, guys. In the next video session, I will explain the next XPath AXES, that is ancestor. Okay, ancestor XPath AXES. So that's it, guys. See you in the next session. Thank you. Bye.